next 2 decades. So what's the message from this map is shrinkage is not a small phenomenon, but it addresses many rural regions, and it expands more and more to Western European contexts. This is also one of the issues which is particularly important to Austria. We have discussed in the ERG context in the past, about 5-7 years ago, this issue in a workshop group with stakeholders from the regions, particularly addressing population decline in the inner areas so in the mountain regions of Styria and Carinthia and in northern Austria, and addressed that issue focusing on the national aspect. Please show the next slide. This is the explanation, so go to the next one. What we found in our analysis of the ESCAPE project was that the types of socioeconomic processes we encounter in shrinking rural regions, they can be very different. And across Europe, we face different situations. These four types, they are not clearly distinct from one another. We have many overlaps between them. So one is economic restructuring, which we faced in the past in most of European regions. Also in Austria, restructuring was very important. But then locational disadvantage comes in for many other regions. This is particularly important with the Western European context, but also in some places of border areas, it might be very important. So as an important issue of the specific location of the regions. But then we have also the experience that large-scale influences, micro-scale processes of spatial reorganization are important to contribute to shrinking processes, which we called under the label peripheralization processes. And particularly in Eastern European countries, we observed disruptive events and political systemic transitions as the main driver for shrinkage. I cannot go into more details. This would be, of course, very different and distinct for the different regions, and we explored this in 8 case studies across Europe. What we found, and this is one of the main messages, is that 60% of predominantly rural regions and intermediate regions affected by demographic decline for all Europe, which covers an area of 40% of the European space and 1/3 of the population. So it's not a minor issue we are dealing with here. Our conclusion is, therefore, that the change of the main policy narrative is required. With escapes from, well, taking these vicious cycles as granted. So we speak, there's no escape from these cycles for disadvantaged areas, peripheral, remote areas. We have many negative terminology on these regions, and we have to escape from those terminology and the narratives that enforce these negative images. This is a crucial issue, and it touches at some aspects that have been slightly mentioned before, when we always focus about growth developments, growth objectives, which can't be the unique or the prime objective in these discussions and strategies. Turning to the consequences or to the lessons for the Austrian Spatial Development Concept 2030, I think the second theme is very important of that concept, has many relationships to our report. That means we have recommendations which address particularly aspects that fine granularity in the analysis and in the response are required, which we also found in the prophecy very strongly, prophecy project, the prophecy ESPON project. So location matters a lot when we deal with such aspects. This is linked also to what Alois Humer just presented on social or public services and their accessibility, as they are very important for the local population. They are also important to address local strengths and potentials and to make them accessible and meaningful for the local population. Of course, and I think I should stop very soon, of course, we should not oversee and neglect the large-scale pressures which are on these regions. Global regimes are very important on these less favored areas, on these shrinking regions. But we have seen through the crisis that these clear-cut divisions are very much shaken. And this might be some aspects, some interesting new phases in the discussion. What we learned particularly in the case studies is that there is a long-term local discontent with how policies are applied to these regions. So they are treated as objects of compensation, which is really disappointing to them and raises very strongly distrust of those populations. This is a result from the research, but I would like to share also that many expressions in recent films, in local initiatives, contesting issues, protest movements, share the same experience. So it's not just a scientific result which is important here. And also when we look at analysis of place-based policies, the aspect of emotions is taken up more and more serious in those reports. So
thank you too much. Do you have one final takeaway message?
One or two messages. One is that the demand from local actors towards us was to achieve practical solutions, so not high-level policy programs, but really practical solutions, which is really a big demand. And the other aspect, but I think this is very relevant to the Austrian discussion as well, and the other is that all these discussions have a particular momentum at the moment. We see in the European Union the discussion on long-term vision for rural regions. We see in OECD a turn towards well-being in regional development aspects. We see in scholarly networks a turn towards rethinking rural as really shaping their future from their own. So I think there is really potential at the moment to discuss these aspects and to have changes that impact on the life chances of rural populations. Thank you.
Thank you very much.